Welcome to the second part of a video series describing PHP Generator's 16.9 new features. In this video, we'll learn how to customize the filter drop-down list values. Let's provide the rating column with an ability to filter data according to the following conditions. Let's assume cool is for movies with rating higher than 7. We'll use good for movies with rating from 5 to 7, and so-so for movies with rating less than 5. To implement such a column filter, open the editor of the movie webpage and the event named onPrepareColumnFilter. This event allows you to customize column filters to be used on this webpage. Here we'll place our code related to a filter customization. The ColumnFilter class provides the setOptionsFor function. Its first argument is a column name. Its second argument is a set of customized filter values. And the third one defines whether the default column filter values will be added to the custom ones. Now save the changes and generate the application to see the results. The rating column header is equipped with the filter button now. The column filter looks and works as planned. Now let's demonstrate how to group filter values. Let's enable a filter for the runtime column and populate it with the following sets of values. Let's use shorter than 90 minutes, 90 to 180 minutes, and longer than 180 minutes. So that the interval of 90 to 180 minutes will be a group of the following intervals. 90 minutes up to 120 minutes, 120 minutes up to 150 minutes, and 150 minutes up to 180 minutes. Let's see how to implement such a filter. Open the onPrepareColumnFilter event editor again and insert the following code. The highlighted code is responsible for grouping of values in the column filter. Now let's see the results. It looks exactly as we planned. Select the movies with runtime 90 minutes up to 120 minutes and 150 minutes up to 180 minutes. The result is okay. Our next goal is to add two more values to the release date column filter. We'll use the year 2010 for movies with release date higher or equal to that value, and 2000s for movies with release dates since 2000 till 2009. Now we need to add the following code to the onPrepareColumnFilter event editor. These lines define custom filter conditions. We set the third argument to true to use default column filter values along with custom ones. Let's save changes and regenerate the project. Voila! Everything is in its place. Let's see how it works. Now we can see the filter work just fine. The filter row above contains the full filter condition. We really hope you enjoyed this feature. Thank you for watching again, and don't forget to like this video and to subscribe to our YouTube channel.